to meet some of the people from Columbine. I got to meet some of the family members of Cassie, Bernal, and Rachel Joy Scott. I got to meet these people and talk to them, and it was amazing to see the impact that the song had for them, just other things that just this courage that they had, this hope that they had. And you know, so often we're so we're so overwhelmed at the idea that somebody died young, and it is a tragedy. But the truth is, we're all gonna die sometime. We just don't know when or where or how. And you shouldn't be surprised that people die. You should be surprised that you are still alive. And so the story goes, the gunman pointed a gun in Cassie Bernal's face and said, "Do you believe in God?" And she said, "Yes," and he shot her and she died. And then he pointed a gun, singling her out because she was a person of faith, because she was a Christian. And he said, "Do you believe in God?" And she said, "Yes." He shot her. She didn't die, so he asked her again, "Do you still believe in God?" She said, "Yes." And he shot her, and she died. And I think it's overwhelming to me to understand something about people who know that they know that they know so much. They know something so firmly. They love something so much. They would die for it. And that's different than taking somebody's life. Different to die for something you believe in. I feel like if we don't have something like that, maybe we're not living. Maybe we're not really living. This song's called Cassie. I will say.